Hello friends, now there is a small topic in frequency response which is important for both GATE and engineering services exam. There were questions from this topic in both GATE and engineering services. That is the step response of the amplifiers. Normally, we make use of amplifiers for amplification of the signals. It can be a voice signal, it can be a pure sinusoidal signals. There are different applications, but normally we make use of amplifiers for amplification of signals. There are rare possibilities that we apply step input, but there is important characteristic of step signals. Please see it carefully. In initial part, at the beginning, this signal, step signal, is increasing sharply, suddenly, instantaneously. So if my amplifier is able to respond to this sharply or suddenly increasing signal, that will indicate the capability of the amplifier to reproduce the fast changing signals. Fast changing signals are those signals. You can see fast changing signals are high frequency signals. So the initial part of the step signal can be used to study the behavior of amplifiers at high frequencies. Fast changing signal. Fast changing signals are what? High frequency signals. Fine. Second part, the top, this flat top of the unit step signal. Flat top of the signal can be used to study the behavior of amplifier to respond to slowly varying signals. Slowly varying signals means if you have these type of slowly varying signals, that is low frequency signals, if I am repeating, this flat top part of the step response can be used to study the behavior of amplifier to slowly varying signals. And slowly varying signals are what? Low frequency signals. So I repeat, this initial part of the step signal can be used to study the high frequency response of the amplifier, and the flat top can be used to study the low frequency response of the amplifier. So that is why we study the behavior of the amplifier for a step signal, and that is nothing but step response of the amplifier. Fine. Now, there are important points to be remembered. I have already discussed. At high frequencies, amplifiers behave like low pass circuit. And at low frequencies, amplifiers behave like high pass circuit. On the basis of what I am concluding, if you remember, the frequency response of the amplifier, at low frequencies, it is behaving like high pass. At high frequencies, it is behaving like low pass. Fine. So, that is the point you should remember. So, for step response, please see it carefully. I will be studying the initial part. I will be using the initial part for what? For studying the high frequency response. And at high frequencies, we have just seen in previous topic, that is high frequency response of common source amplifier. At high frequencies, your amplifier is behaving like what? Low pass circuit. And if you draw the circuit, that is low pass RC circuit. So what is a low pass RC circuit? So I will be using low pass RC circuit to study the behavior of amplifier at high frequencies when we are giving the step input. So input here is input to this. This is input signal. This is output signal. Fine. This is 1 by SC. This is R. This is your step input signal. Fine. Now, for step input, in case of low pass RC circuit, I'll be using terms R1, C1 just for distinction from second part. R1, C1. Fine. So for frequency domain, I can use S or I can use J omega. It is your choice, pure your choice. So in this case, I will be using simply C1. So when you apply step input to a low pass RC circuit, so what is the response? This capacitor will start charging exponentially like this. Remember, capacitor does not charge suddenly, it will be charging exponentially. Fine. Now, at certain point of time, say this is voltage V, if amplitude of this voltage is V, at certain point of time, it will reach to 90% of its initial value, 0.9. That time is called rise time. Fine. But rise time is not only that time. I will be using two values. One value is T2 and one value is T1. This is 0.1 volt. So what is rise time of low pass circuit or rise time of amplifier, you can say? The rise time of low pass circuit or rise time of amplifier is the time required to change the output voltage from 10% to 90% of its final value. What will be final value in this case? That is equal to input voltage. Finally, when capacitor is fully charged, the voltage across capacitor will be what? V. So finally, voltage will reach to V. But when you talk about rise time, the rise time is the time required to change from the initial value of 10% of the final, from 10% to 90% of final value. So this time period is called rise time. Please do remember this. Fine. So now, how to calculate this? How to find this? Let us see that. The voltage across simple low pass RC circuit is given by 1 minus e raised to power minus t by the time constant of this circuit is R1 C1 multiplied by its final value. Final value is what? V. So this is the expression of voltage across the capacitor. That is output voltage. Fine. So we will be talking about quiescence at t is equal to T1. What is V naught T1? That is equal to 0.1 V. So this gives 0.1 volt equal to V 1 minus e raised to power minus T1 by R1 C1. So I can make use of calculator and I can write it directly rather than going for mathematical calculation. So T1 is equal to 0.1 R1 C1. Please write it directly or remember it directly. Fine. Right? Similarly, at T is equal to T2, what is the output voltage? The output voltage is 0.9 V. At t equal to t2, it is 0.9 V. So this gives 0.9 V is equal to V into 1 minus e raised to power minus t2 by R1 C1. Fine. So this gives t2 equal to, you can write it directly, that is nothing but 2.3 R1 C1. You can calculate with calculator, you can find this value, but you should remember it directly. So what will be rise time? The rise time is T2 minus T1. So that is 2.3 R1 C1 minus 0.1 R1 C1. Or this gives rise time of this circuit equal to 2.2 R1 C1. Right? Now, so what we get? The rise time of this circuit is what? Remember, I am representing this circuit as amplifier. Because at high frequencies, your amplifier behaves like low pass RC circuit. So I'm studying the behavior of amplifier with the help of low pass RC circuit. So what do we get? TR equal to 2.2 R1 C1. But remember, what is the cutoff frequency? What upper cutoff frequency in terms of R1 C1 is what? 1 by 2 pi R1 C1. That is the cutoff frequency of this circuit, that is low pass circuit. Or I can say R1 C1 is equal to what? R1 C1 is 1 by 2 pi FH. So T rise time, you can replace R1 C1 by this, that is 2.2 divided by 2 pi into FH, right? And you can calculate this further. This is what, 3.14 or approximately 6, divide it by 6. So that is equal to 0.35 by upper cutoff frequency. This expression is very, very important. You must remember this, the rise time of amplifiers. You have lot of questions. This topic is important from communication engineering point of view also. In communication engineering, there is sometimes we talk about rise time of amplifiers. This is there. Sometimes we talk rise time of amplifiers in CRO. That is this. This puts limits on bandwidth of CRO in measurement also. So this is very, very important expression. The rise time of any amplifier or rise time of low pass RC circuit is nothing but 0.35 divided by cutoff frequency, upper cutoff frequency. So you have lot of questions based on this formula, and I hope you will remember it. On based on this, there will be one question I will be discussing at later stage, which appeared in GATE exam in electronics. But I hope you understand the importance of topic and you will remember that this complete analysis is garbage. You don't need to go for analysis. That was just to make you understand. The important thing is this formula. Try to remember this formula directly. Don't go for mathematical expression. Don't go for derivation. There is a rare possibility that they ask you the derivation. But do remember that final formula. I will give you one example based on that. But at later stage I can discuss now itself. That's a simple question. That question was an amplifier is assumed to have a single pole high frequency transfer function. That's the transfer function we have already discussed for low pass circuit. The rise time of its response is to a step function is 35 nanosecond. TR is 35 nanosecond, that is given to you. Fine. Upper 3 dB cutoff frequency of the amplifier is, you have to find upper 3 dB cutoff frequency. So you know what is FH? FH is nothing but 0.35 divided by rise time from this formula, and that is 35 nanoseconds. So you can simply write the expression, and that gives the frequency in megahertz, and that is how much? That is 10 megahertz. This is one small numerical. So there are number of numericals which have appeared from this in engineering. This is very important for engineering services, and this is the question which appeared in GATE. I'm not talking about only engineering services. So I hope you will remember this formula directly. Now, another but important topic, that is what? That is the small, this was initial part. I was talking about to study the behavior due to this abrupt change. Now I'll try to see the response of the amplifier for that remaining part. Fine. And flat top of the step. Flat top of the step is used to study the behavior of amplifier at which frequencies? At low frequencies. And at low frequencies, your amplifier behaves like what? It behaves like high pass RC circuit. So this was low pass RC circuit to study the initial part of the signal. But for studying the response of the amplifier at flat top, that means at this portion, I will be using what? I will be using high pass RC circuit because amplifier at low frequencies behave like high pass RC circuit. So I will be using this circuit. Fine. So you can simply take CR, you can take C2R2, you can take C1R1, that is your material. So don't go for this subscript C2 or R2. Fine. So the point is you should understand the concept. The concept is more important. Now, please see it carefully. When you apply, when you give a step input to this, when you give step input is steady state input. So what will be the behavior? Behavior of this amplifier. This is output, you know what? This is time. So in case of low pass circuits, initially the output, say this is input, magnitude is V, this is T. Fine. When you apply voltage across this, the capacitor initially behaves like short circuit, but it starts charging gradually. So initially this voltage V appears across this and it reduces exponentially. Fine. It starts reducing exponentially. But if time constant of the circuit is large, this will be varying almost linearly, but not linearly. It will be varying exponentially. There is no doubt about it, like this. But that will be varying slowly. Fine. Right. Now we have like this. So please see carefully. Initially it was V, that much voltage, but after that it starts reducing. Fine. So at certain point of time, this is say V1. Fine. Or V dash, I can say. Say it is V dash. Fine. So after how much time? Say that is equal to T1. So we know the output voltage of RC circuit is equal to what? 1 minus please remember, here output voltage is reducing, it is not increasing. Right? So the expression for voltage across the capacitor is V into e raised to power minus T by time constant of the circuit is C2 R2. C1 R1 or C2 R2, I repeat, that is immaterial. You can use any of the subscript. Fine. So this can be written like this, 1 minus T by R2. C2, for which if time constant R2 C2, if time constant R2 C2 is large, in that case V0 T can be written approximately equal to this. Fine. Now at T is equal to T1, what is V naught? That is equal to what? V dash. So this gives V dash equal to V1 minus T by R2 C2. Fine. So now see it carefully again. This is T1. Right? So from here we define what? This change, percentage change over a period of time is what? V minus V dash. So we define percentage tilt in the output. I repeat, it was slowly varying signal, it was signal, but output is not remaining constant, output is reducing. So in case of my amplifier which is behaving like high pass RC circuit at low frequencies, output will not be giving a same amplitude as input. It's reducing, amplitude is reducing. Or rather than saying reducing, basically it is changing, decreasing with time. Maybe this was simple RC circuit. In case of amplifier, input amplitude multiplied by some amplification factor, that should be the constant output, but that is reducing here, that is reducing because of this capacitance. Fine. So this percentage tilt is nothing but that percent tilt is defined as the percent tilt of the amplifier is defined as V minus V dash divided by V, that is original value, into 100. And you can see if you define the percentage tilt, that is this reduction, V minus V dash, you can see from here that will be what? T1 by R2 C2 into 100. Why? Because V minus V dash, take V dash on that side. So V minus V dash is T1 by R2 C2. Fine. Divide by V. So that will be your percent tilt. Fine. Now, suppose I give a periodic signal at input like this. Right? And this T, it means I am giving a periodic signal whose this period is equal to maybe half of the period. Fine. I repeat, suppose I give a periodic signal and this T1 is equal to T/2, half of the period of that periodic signal. In that case, how can you find the tilt? You know, percentage tilt here is equal to T1 by, what is R2 C2? Remember, R2 C2 is, if you remember, in case of high pass circuit, this is high pass circuit. In case of high pass circuit, we define in case of high pass, this is high pass circuit. In case of high pass circuit, we define a lower cutoff frequency, and that is 2 pi by C2 R2. That is lower cutoff frequency of this amplifier. So what will be C2 R2? So in that case, C2 R2 for this amplifier will be 1 by 2 pi into FL. So I can replace this C2 R2 by this. So this will be what? T1 multiplied by 2 pi into FL. But if input is periodic signal with T1 equal to T/2, or that is 1/2f, half of the time period of the input signal. In case of amplifier, we have normally periodic signals. So if input is periodic signal with T1 equal to half of the period of that, you put it here, what do we get? Percentage tilt will be equal to, that is pi FL divided by F into 100. This is percentage tilt, and percentage tilt is directly proportional to the lower cutoff frequency of the amplifier. Fine. So if you have the square wave type of input to this circuit, suppose you have a square wave type of input to this amplifier like this, this is V input, this is output, that is square wave. So what will happen? Initially the output will be reducing like this, but here it will be changing suddenly. Again, it will be reducing like this on negative part. It will be reducing like this on negative part. It will be reducing like this. So output of the amplifier will be like this. This is the question which appeared in exams, in many exams. When there is a square wave input to an amplifier, the output is a tilted wave like this. Question is important for engineering services. You will find a question in engineering services. If input to what? Low pass RC circuit. I'm sorry, this is high pass RC circuit. If input to high pass RC circuit is a square wave, the output is like this tilted wave. there can be question based on this. You will find many questions in Indian services. Try to remember this directly. That percentage tilt you can remember. Access, there are very few questions based on this formula, but there are many questions based in this waveform. So I hope you will understand and remember that expression. So this is the, that is response, a step response of amplifiers, important for objective type questions. So I hope the concept is clear and you will remember that. Thank you very much for watching the video. In next video, we will be talking about the noise of different amplifiers, or noise in BJT amplifiers I'll be talking about. Thank you.